you're like, you'd probably do that to me. Oh, I might. But then again, just like your sticks, you never used them tonight, wasn't planning on using them tonight. I just wanted to know who was going to bring them. So I may never call you up to say your 3 goals, but I might. Okay? Well, I might. So I go, hey, bring your 3 goals, and you go, oh, I don't have them here. Well, where are they? I don't know. Do you even have goals? What are you doing here? And then I start questioning. Then I start holding what? What's that? The calendar. Then right side wrote. So all my other coaches, they know exactly the level of what we want. We're going to drive you there, gentlemen. We're going to drive you there. You will get there. So I'm giving you some tools that's going to help you out. So that's what I'm looking. Now, there's a couple of guidelines or models I want you to use. This is called a FITS model. F-I-T-S. Okay, F stands for fit. Does this goal fit for what I'm doing here in these next 2 months? So write that down, very important. So F stands for fit, F-I-T. Does this goal fit what we're doing at this camp? 2, is it an important goal? Or are you just throwing stuff out there? It has to be important to you because that importance will drive you to be better. So it has to be important. 3, timing. Is this the right time for this goal? Is it timing enough? Is 2 months enough? Is it too much, this goal? Is this a goal that might have to be done for the next 5 years to obtain, and the timing is not right because the timing is 2 months? And some of these goals may not fit in 2 months either as we go along, but that timing is important. And 4th, and most important, which I have not said this word yet, but simplicity. How simple is this goal? It can't be a complicated goal. In 2 months, it needs to be a simple goal. It might be one thing that you want to accomplish away from the puck. One thing with it, maybe one thing off the ice. I don't know. But it needs to be simple. Just like the practices I've given you. They're simple practices if we do them. So simplicity is really key. Okay? And then, of course, I'm going to put it down here. I think most of you have probably seen this if you've gone to academies. And that's SMART goals. Okay? So you're gonna go through that simple FITS model, make sure that it sort of aligns with everything that we're doing here, and the time commitment and all those things, very quick and easy to go through. Well, I should say quick and easy, but it should be simpler than what the SMART goals will be. The S stands for specific, so it needs to be a specific goal. You're not gonna put down, I wanna be a goal scorer. Well, we all do. But what does that mean? No different than you, right? You're doing visualization, but you couldn't give it to me specifically, right? It's okay. But that's what we need to be, and that's why I want the parents to help you to make sure it's dialed in to what you're actually wanting to do. Okay? The second one is measurable. So how can I measure this goal? How do I know I'm getting better at it? So can I actually measure this goal? Right? And so that might be done through you doing extra work at home. It might be done through watching what's happening with the camp. Right, you guys might be on some spring teams. Okay, what we're doing here at this camp, is it actually correlating to your game? And if it's not, that's a problem. That's something else we need to discuss with you on why that's not happening. Right? So again, you gotta be measurable. And then the third one, is it achievable? Like, is it even achievable? Like, is this an achievable goal or like sort of out in left field? And really, this, like again, like I said, it's gonna take 3 to 4 to 5 months to really achieve. Can this be done in a time allotted? Okay? Is it realistic? There's a lot of people have goals and it's not even realistic. Like it's sort of, you know, unattainable for right now. Right? And so what happens when it's not attainable? What happens? You lose what? Interest. And you just let the goals go. And you never go back to it, and then again the monkey mind's running around, and you're just in the woods going every which direction that you feel like going, and nothing really gets accomplished. I mean, us adults can say that we've gone through that, we've done that. We might be doing it right now. But we've got to make sure it's realistic. But be honest with yourself. Don't be afraid of that. Take the walls down. And be honest with yourself. Like, this is really going to work. Right? Does that make sense? Okay, and the last one is time sensitive. And I talked about, you know, it's a goal too short, too long. You know, you gotta be, you know, with that goal, there might be some things. There's goals that you'll pick that are like 10-year goals, right? I'm trying to do this. It might be lifetime goals, but you're trying to do all that. Oh, that pen just jumped out of your hand? Holy cow. It's a good thing, just leave it there. Because that thing almost hit you in the eye. What took your eye out? You might want to wear your helmet. Okay, so you gotta be time sensitive to that. Make sure it's time sensitive. It's in that time frame that things can get done. You might pick a goal that's a little beyond the 2 months. So you might stress that a little bit, and you got some other camps that you're going to that can work on that. Right? I'll leave that up to you. I want you to do this with your parents. I know for some of you, like, oh no, come on, you're killing me right now. I gotta sit down across the table with these guys? Yes. Because I want to make sure that is the goals for you. They know you better than anyone. I don't know you well enough to say what those are. Right? Does that make sense? So, those are the four areas of mental toughness. That's the start. There's a lot of other things that we've done with my clients, like gratitude practice, journaling. There's a lot of other things. There's other practices and models that we've done with them. But this is probably a good start for you guys to look at. Alright? And these are things that you can do every day for a few minutes just to gain control. My advice is that you try it. And be determined and keep doing it for a long period of time. Meditation is another one that can help you gain witness really quick. But I'm telling you right now, visualization, self-talk, and the breathing, those three things, if you brought that into your goals, you would see more success. The two 17-year-olds are proving that it happens. Client one did it. We did it. There's no question. Very proud of that. The client two, I'm really proud of. Because he is living, he's actually physically changing his life. Right? He's taking all the stuff out of the bed. Stuff out. He's cleaning everything up, this crap. It's just laying around, cluttering his mind. He's getting rid of it. Did I tell him to do that? No. Did not. He did it on his own. Him and his sister fight a lot. You know what's happening with that relationship now? They're getting stronger and they're spending time together more. Because he's witnessing his negative self-talk about his sister. On his own. The practices, and they're spending time together doing things for each other, helping each other. He actually felt regret. He didn't go pick up a sister at the U of A when she phoned for him to help him. Typically, that never bothered him before, but in the last session, it bothered him. He had regret. So now, I don't know how he's going to deal with regret. It says to be long-lasting. You probably should want to do something for your sister next time she calls you, so that you feel better, and that you know better. He felt really bad at that meeting. All on his own. But what he's doing is he's allowing his brain to relax. And he's starting to look. He's starting to realize certain things in his life he needs to change. And he's making that change. It's a remarkable thing to him. So I'm trying to give you that gift. I'm trying to give that gift to you. I can't do it for you, neither can your parents. Take ownership and be better people at the end of the day. Lord knows this world needs better people. You guys are the future leaders, possibly of towns, cities, provinces, countries in the world. And we need to support you guys as adults. And I think at times when I look at this world, we are failing. And so I'll do my little part here in this little part of the world to try to make you even better than you need. That makes sense. So this is much more than hockey to me. This is about it. It will help your hockey for sure. But it'll make you really good people. Not that you aren't now, but it'll make you better. That makes sense? So any questions? Alright, so all you're thinking. No, you're good? Breathing, visualization, right? Self-talk, and goal setting. Have your wills ready for the first gate, John, that you never know what may come out of my mouth. Be ready. Be ready for anything. Because I might say something in the drill and how I want it, and I might change it without telling you, and you need to be in the moment. Because I always got stuff on my sleeve to test. Because I will test you, and Tony will test you. Are there any questions on that? All right, parents, any questions? Now, if you have any, please come and ask or email. Like, it's all there. I'll help out the kids as much as I can. When we leave, what do we always do?
I don't know.